Hey everybody, today we're gonna be making an Instant Pot Shrimp Scampi recipe. It has a 3-minute cook time and it is absolutely scrumptious and I can't wait to show you how to make it. Keep watching this video and we're gonna go through the steps right now. Hey, hey everyone, welcome to the Four and Fork. My name is Alexandria and this is the Four and Fork where we are cooking one meal from every country in the world. And today we are making an Instant Pot Shrimp Scampi recipe, which is divine because it's a dump and go recipe, which means that you just put it all in the pot, put the lid on, cook it, and then it is ready to eat in a literal 3-minute cook time. So you are gonna love this recipe. Let's get started. In order to make this recipe, you're gonna need to have your Instant Pot or any other pressure cooker. And into that pressure cooker, you're gonna put 1¾ cups of chicken broth, 1/4 cup of white wine, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 2 teaspoons of garlic, and 2 tablespoons of butter. It can be cold or softened, doesn't matter. You're also gonna need 8 ounces, so 1/2 pound, of angel hair pasta. And your pasta is gonna be dry because it's gonna cook right in the liquid that's in the pressure cooker right now. So if you've watched any of my other videos before that use spaghetti, such as my cacio e pepe recipe in the Instant Pot, you would know that we can't put the noodles in like this because they're not gonna fit. So what we need to do instead is take a grouping of them, stick our hands kind of in the pot so that, you know, they don't break all over the place, and we're gonna break them in half and then put them in the liquid. I love cooking my pasta in the pressure cooker because when you cook on the stovetop, you cook in water, right? But when you cook your pasta in the pressure cooker, you cook it in chicken broth, and that gives it so much more flavor. It's awesome. All right, now we have all of our pasta in the pressure cooker. We need to make sure that it's all covered in liquid. So I'm gonna use my wooden spoon and just kinda press all of the noodles and make sure that they get submerged in the liquid. If they're not submerged, they're not gonna cook right. And then lastly, we have 1 pound of deveined, detailed, raw shrimp that you're gonna put on top of the noodles. The shrimp that I'm using today, I bought frozen and then I thawed it. Sometimes I buy it directly thawed from the fish counter. You can do that too. You can also put it in here completely frozen and it will thaw it before it starts cooking. And then your pressure building time might be a little bit longer, but it'll all be the same in the end. You don't need to change the cook time or anything. Once you have all the ingredients in the pressure cooker, you just need to put the lid on, turn it to pressure, and then we're gonna set the timer for 3 minutes on high. Once the timer has reached zero, once the pasta has cooked all the way in the pressure cooker, you're gonna perform a quick release, which means that we're gonna let the pressure out of the pressure cooker quickly instead of letting it release naturally. Oh man, we got some cooked scampi ready for enjoyment. If you looked inside this pot, you might notice that right now there's a little bit extra liquid in there. That's totally fine. When pasta cooks in the Instant Pot or pressure cooker, sometimes there's some liquid left behind, but it always soaks it up in the first like 5 minutes. So don't be worried if there's a little bit of extra liquid in there more than what you were expecting. It'll soak it up eventually. And now the only thing left to do is sprinkle some parsley on top because every good scampi comes with parsley, right? So we have 1/3 cup of chopped parsley that I will just sprinkle on top for good measure there, mostly just to make it look beautiful. And then some Parmesan cheese for each individual plating. And look, you can already tell that the extra liquid has been soaked up. Now it's nice and juicy, the good sauce on there. I only got 3 shrimp, I think I need more. I'm one of those people that never says when at the Italian restaurant. The more Parmesan cheese, the better in my opinion. That is heaven. It's so easy cooking the pasta right in the pressure cooker, and it's so much more flavorful than a shrimp scampi that you would make on the stove because everything is cooked all together. I love making my shrimp scampi this way, so I hope that you like this recipe too. If you ever need links to so that you can read the full instructions that are written out, there'll be a link to that in the description of the video. And then don't forget to check out all the other recipes that are on my YouTube channel. I have Instant Pot recipes, I have recipes from all around the world, and I have some Instant Pot recipes from all around the world. So you get the best of both worlds there. Thank you so much for watching the video. Don't forget to bring some culture to your kitchen this week, and I will see you next week. Bye.